Hey guys! So after featuring this tank in my latest video, I got a few requests asking me about making a video about my Congo tetras. So in case you guys don't know which ones of those fish are the Congos, those are the ones. It's mostly males, but I got three females, which are the chunky, less colorful ones. So where are these fish from? Well, like their name says it, they're from the Democratic Republic of Congo, which is in Africa. And according to my experience with these fish, those are one of the hardiest tetras I have kept. Like, they're really hardy. They're also quite big. Males get up to 3 inches and females are slightly smaller, but you also have to take in consideration their finish size. They have long fins and they're really, really pretty. There's two types of Congo tetra. There's the lampe eye, which I don't have in this tank, but I'll add a picture right here. And there's the regular Congo tetra, which you're looking at right now. And these guys, they live in rivers in Congo, and they live from 3 to 5 years, but possibly longer, possibly, if you really take care of them. They live on a diet of basically plant matter and fly larvae and little worms and stuff like that. So they're omnivores. They're really cool fish. Like, they're not hard to feed in aquariums. Just they accept lake food, they accept anything really. And the minimal size you should get, it's the minimal size according to the interwebs. It says 40 gallon, but honestly 40 gallons is a bit tight for them. Like, if you think about adults getting up to 3 inches, 40 gallon, I don't know. Well, you kind of see in the reflection my turtle thing below, if you really look like past what I'm showing you. Okay, so aside the turtle being in my video, these guys, behavior, it's pretty good. Like, don't put them with any really aggressive fish because they'll nip their fins off, but they hold their own. They nip each other amongst each other, but no real damage. Like, they're community fish overall. And reproduction, it's hard to breed them in captivity. Like, they've never bred for me. You'd have to like really well replicate their environment because they're egg scatterers. And in order for those eggs to survive, I mean, it's not a river, it's an aquarium. So yeah, I don't know. You have to, I guess, wait until they scatter their eggs, if they ever do, and then perhaps remove the adults to prevent them from eating it. But that means you'll have to have at least 2 40-gallon tanks to do so. So yeah, you gotta be really motivated in order to breed them. And the difference between male and female, well, let me zoom in. Here's a male and here's a female. I mean, the difference is there. The male's got to be really, really pretty to impress her, and she doesn't have to work that much. So I got in here like 3 females and 6 males, I believe. Oh, one other thing, the temperature, between 23 and 28, anywhere around that is fine. pH, they're really tolerant, between like 6 and 8. Like, I had them in all sorts of tanks, and I don't know, as long as it's stable, basically with any fish, as long as it's like stable temperatures, stable pH, they don't really care what you do with them. And yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it was informational enough for your liking, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. All right, see you soon guys. Bye.